All right, so this next section, I'm going to show you how to use areas. The areas link is a link that's going to help you create pages for your certain neighborhoods or communities or whatever. And it will help you with kind of targeting the areas that you are trying to kind of, if you're doing a farm and you want to kind of master that community, you definitely want to create an area page for that community, that subdivision, that zip code or whatever. And it will help you be found online a little bit better. So, and it does some really cool features for you. So we're going to go ahead and get into it. But of course, by coming in here from your sites, and you're going to come over here where it says view details. And we're going to come across where it says areas. And we're going to click on areas. And I've already created one area just for fun. And I'm going to create a second area so you can kind of see how they work. So we're going to come over here to where it says areas. We're going to click on that. And we're going to scroll on down, and what we're going to do is we're going to figure out what is the area page title. So I'm going to go ahead and do a subdivision. So Liberty at Paradise. It's just a little subdivision that is in Henderson, Nevada, and it's right next to a growing college right now, or whatever, Nevada State. And so it's a great little neighborhood, and it's, of course, it's a good price point for the entrance or people, first-time home buyers and stuff. So types of area. Now there's four ways you can kind of check on this. You could pick on, you're going to click on county, you can click on region, you could do locality, you could do postal, or which is zip codes, or neighborhood. So if I was searching for Liberty of Paradise, I could actually click on neighborhood, and I'll check and see if it's there. So I'm going to go ahead and click on neighborhood. And from here, I'm going to click on the little drop down, and I'm going to scroll on down. There's like a zillion neighborhoods in here. So I'm going to check out. And there is no Liberty at Paradise. So I wouldn't be able to go ahead and use, and I don't know how these subdivisions or properties become or neighborhoods become available in here. I found the other one, the other subdivision that I was doing was in there, but this one is not. So I don't know exactly how to submit a subdivision. So we're not going to do neighborhood. What we're going to do is I'm going to click on this, and I'm going to do postal, which all it's going to do is I'm just going to pick the zip code, and it's going to be a little larger area. And it's really not that big of a deal when it comes to the map or whatever, and it's from the properties that are going to be pulled in. But that is not a big issue or a big deal here. But anyway, we're going to go ahead and create the type of area, which will be based off of zip codes. All right, from here, we're just going to go ahead and click on name of area, and we're going to look for the zip code. And the zip code on this one is 89002. So we'll just type that in. It pulls up. And then it said, should this area be featured? Well, I can have it featured. I'm not going to have this one featured, but if I wanted to, I'd go ahead and do that. And it, depending on what theme you have, will display that area. And then it's going to say slideshow photos. This image, they should be the 16 by 600. I'm going to add a couple of images so you can kind of see what it looks like. So I'm going to go ahead and click upload file. I'm going to go ahead and click on this image, which is an image of the Black Mountain. This is kind of a look from the neighborhood. And I'll upload another image here. I'm gonna upload just a picture of the high school. Now, both of these are large pictures, and you can see that they're not exactly the 116 by 600. And so you'll be able to see how, if you don't have them that size, it's going to crop them the way they want it rather than the way you want it. But that's okay. For this example, you'll be able to see kind of what it looks like. And it's just basically using the exact same slider that you use on your home page. So we're going to scroll on down here. And the headline is going to be Liberty of Paradise. And then we're going to have a little bit of content. Body of the copy. I'm going to go ahead and I've already written a little bit of stuff from one of the subdivisions. So we are going to come over here and we're going to use this little top part here. Copy this. So you just sit here and write a little bit of copy. And then it says full width image, or I could have with a little bit of information on it. I'm gonna go ahead and upload a full width image so you can kind of see what that looks like. We're gonna click on upload file. I'm gonna use the logo from the high school and put that in there. We're gonna go ahead and type in Foothill. No, I'm gonna write in Great Schools. And I'm going to copy the section in this section that I was kind of talking about. Schools. This one talks about schools. Copy this. I'm going to go ahead and paste that in the body. And then I'm going to scroll down a little bit more. And I could add some half width image to the left or half width image to the right. So I'm just going to go ahead and place an image there so you can kind of see what that looks like. And I'm going to go ahead and use the half width image to the left. So we're going to click on this one, upload this. And I just grabbed a picture that was from the rec center. It's kind of a cool little rec center. And I'm going to put that in there. And then we're going to go ahead and scroll down. We're going to talk about Great Entertainment, and that's going to be all of this community stuff right here. I'm going to copy this. And you just go ahead and write whatever you wanted to in here, and I'm going to remove the college thing because we've already added that part in there. We're going to scroll on down a little bit more. And then it's going to go ahead and say the excerpt. This is basically just a little blurb that we want to be saying about the community. So we're going to go, perfect. Liberty of Paradise, great schools, great community, beautiful views. And then we're going to scroll on down here and it says featured image. We're going to go ahead and click choose file. And I'm going to use an image that we have of the subdivision from the sky. Click open. Now down here at the bottom, of course, and then all you need to do is go ahead and put the SEO information in here for the meta title and meta description. So perfect. So I wrote a little meta title and meta description. Again, needs to be 55 letters or spaces, characters, and 155 for the meta description. We come on over here and we click on save. And now what we've got here is we've got two of the areas showing. Now, one of the most important things that we need to do is we need to, just because the areas are there, does not mean that they're going to be showing on our website. So we need to come over here to pages. And we actually have to create an areas page. So we're going to come on over here and click on pages. I'm going to scroll on down here and it's going to be, we're going to click on the template and we're going to scroll on down where it says areas index. And this is going to be specialized neighborhoods. So we're just going to call it specialized neighborhoods here. And then we could write a little bit of content on here. So here's some great communities that I love using, whatever, right? And then what we're going to do is we're going to add both of these communities, one that I just created, Liberty at Paradise, and then here's Paradise Hills. Do I want to add this page to the menu? Yes, I do. We're going to scroll on down here, and we're going to use, again, meta title, meta description. We always want to create those on here. All right, perfect. I just wrote a little title and description. We're going to come down here and click save. And we can edit the menu. We're just going to go ahead and close it, actually. And we're going to come over here now and view live site. I want to see where it says specialized neighborhoods. That is the area page that we created. So we're going to go ahead and click on that. And you'll notice a couple of things. Here's specialized neighborhoods. You've got Liberty of Paradise, and then you've got Paradise Hills. Here's my little gibberish that I wrote at the very top. And it's got a little bit of blurb on here. So Liberty of Paradise, great schools, great community, beautiful views, great neighborhood and great schools. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on more. And what you're gonna see is this slider that we created. Now remember, we didn't crop those pictures. What the website did is took the two pictures that were big enough, which were 1600 by 600, and made it fit so it would just be a slider along the top here. So these are the slider pictures that is going across the top of the page, and then we're gonna scroll on down. And here's the content of Liberty at Paradise. We're gonna scroll down a little bit more. There's the full-size picture that we used for the content, and we're gonna scroll down a little bit more, and it says Great Schools, and it talked about the Great Schools. And then this is the picture that we use for images on the left, and it talked about the Great Entertainment. And this, you'll notice, this is showing, this neighborhood is actually right in this area right here. But what you'll notice is because I used the zip code, it's pulling all of the properties that fit in the zip code of this area. Okay, and it's showing all the nearby listings by that zip code. All right, so that's the difference between community. If it was a community, it would only show the homes in that subdivision. And then what's happening is it's pulling all the properties. So there's 17 properties that are listed on this map that fall by, that are in the same zip code, and you can do it by price and beds and bath or whatever. But now it's gonna have automatic searches for that zip code. Pretty cool. So that is what we're dealing with here. Let's go ahead and go back to specialized neighborhoods, and I can kind of show you the other neighborhood that I created. We'll go to Paradise Hills. You click on that. And again, it's got the slider, you'll see, that's coming across the top here. And then what this is the main image. So then it's just got the pictures of the house and Great Neighborhood, Great Schools, just stuff, the headers that I wrote. Now, if you notice on this one, this also has the zip code. I changed it to zip code, but if it was going to be a subdivision, then I would actually just put I think it's called community, and it would, this community only is in this area right here, okay? So you'll just notice if you do zip code or postal, it'll pull the zip code. If it does community, it'll pull that area, just that subdivision for the searches. And then of course the nearby listings. So that is how you do communities. Awesome way for you to be able to be found online.